The astronomy department was founded in the early 1960s, and the observatory was founded in 1968. In recent years, we've expanded the department to the study of supernovae, which are the most powerful explosions we know of in the universe.
I'm most involved in a new type of supernova called superluminous supernovae. So these are much brighter than other types of supernovae that have been found before. It's kind of an exciting field because we don't know exactly what these are. We just know that they put out a tremendous amount of energy, and how they actually do that is something that's being actively researched and I'm very involved in uncovering.
We currently have two research grade telescopes. The bigger of the two is a 40-inch telescope. And then, of course, our new telescope, the Phillips Claud Telescope. It is a 1.25 meter reflecting telescope. It's about 50 inches in diameter, making that telescope the largest telescope at Mount Laguna Observatory. The best aspect of this new telescope is that it's going to be eventually a robotic telescope. That means it's going to move around during the night from one object to another under computer control, enable us to observe a large number of different interesting objects without human intervention. And that's going to really improve the efficiency of the operation of this telescope.
I need to monitor supernova for a long period of time, for months often, and I need to do it every night. And I can't do that unless I have a robotic telescope like this that can take those observations for me while I sleep, or else I'll go crazy. So this is very important for my sanity, for my family, and for my research.
In days gone by, telescopes were scheduled in a very different way than they're typically scheduled now. In the old days, an astronomer would apply for time and they would get a certain number of nights on a telescope, maybe 3 nights, where they would have the telescope to themselves. And that wasn't the most efficient way to run an observatory or a telescope, because a lot of times an astronomer would have a specific object in mind they wanted to observe. That object would be up for part of the night and not the rest of the night. Nowadays, with automated telescopes, it's possible to have many different astronomers have a certain amount of time allocated on the telescope each night.
You know, the night sky is a little bit different every night. There's a supernova tonight that wasn't there the night before. And that's where a telescope like this comes in play. You don't necessarily have to look deeper than the other telescopes are looking or farther. You just have to be there at the right place at the right time.